One of the most touching stories, I recorded it the other night, but I don't think the audio worked. It didn't pick up, was the stick man drawing.
Oh, yeah. Well, the first year I was here, and I was about as green as you could be, you know, doing mission work up in these mountains, and I could not speak any Spanish yet. I moved into the village not being able to speak Spanish, and I wanted to learn Spanish, so I decided not to move in with a translator. And that would really force me to learn the language. But I was living in a room at a clinic that we had just refurbished, and because my days were so full, the only time I really had to just read God's word and pray and have some alone time was early in the morning. So about 5:30 every morning, I'd go out on the porch of the clinic and I would be reading my Bible. And this man who lives in the village, his name is Gilberto, he's been deaf since he was a baby, he had polio. And he would walk down the road every morning while I was sitting out on the porch, and every morning he would wave on his way to with his machete to go work in the field. And that went on for quite a while, until one morning he was walking past, but instead of walking past, he entered the yard of the clinic. He walked up to the porch, walked into the clinic, into the waiting room. He grabbed a chair, and he came and he sat next to me, and he sat down, and then he put his finger on my Bible, and he was tapping it like this. He wanted to know what that book was. And all I could remember doing is just praying, "Oh, Father, I how do I teach a man who cannot hear, he cannot read? I have no way, I don't know how to communicate your word to him." And the only thing that came, I mean, it literally came right at that moment was, "Get some paper and pencil. You can draw stick men and stick figures." And I ran into the clinic and I got some printer paper out of the printer and a pencil and sat down with him and started with Genesis and just started drawing and pointing and whatever it took. And about 3 hours later, we got to the cross and to the story of his Savior dying for him and his sin. And at the moment that he understood the story, he jumped up and he grabbed his shirt right over his heart, and the tears were just running down his face, and he had his hand lifted up to heaven, and he, in his very guttural sounds that a deaf person can make, was just, he was praying. I have no idea what he was saying, but God knew, and I could tell by his reaction he knew exactly what Jesus did for him. And all I can say is it was the Holy Spirit, because I'm not that good of an artist. I draw stick figures. And stick figures just generally don't teach us a whole lot of spiritual truths.
That's right.
So God uses our just little weak ways that we try so hard as humans, you know, our simple little things that we try to do. He uses those to do mighty things. And in this man's life, he just worked a mighty deed through his spirit, just through some stick figures.
And we passed him a little while ago.
Yeah, we passed him a little while ago, sitting down in the village. Yeah.
That is awesome.
A real sweet little man.